Our sun rotates on its axis roughly once a month. This is something we've known about since 1611, when Johann Fabricius used his telescope to watch sunspots track across the surface of the sun. But in 1996, an international team of researchers made a surprising discovery. The outer layer of the sun seems to be spinning slower than the layers beneath it. And not only that, it seems to be slowing down further. So why is this happening? What in the vacuum of space could apply drag to the surface of the sun? Well, first, maybe we should take a step back and ask how we know what's happening inside the sun at all, given it's an intensely glowing ball of plasma 150 million kilometers away. Well, the key is the solar equivalent of earthquakes. Turbulence in the convection zone causes massive vibrations, and due to the internal structure and composition of the sun, certain frequencies get amplified by constructive interference, making the sun ring like a bell. These seismic waves reflect off the photosphere, which is the visible surface of the sun, so we can literally see the resonant vibrations in our star. Scientists use these observations to infer the internal structure of the sun, just like an ultrasound. And what they saw was the outer layer of the sun is rotating slower than the interior, but they couldn't explain why. But now scientists think they have an answer. A clue comes from an old observation about dust particles orbiting around stars. You might expect them just to orbit forever, like the planets around the sun, but that's not what happens. Instead, they gradually lose energy and spiral into the star. The source of drag on the dust particles is not friction. They lose energy even if they never collide with anything. That is, except for light from the star. Now, from the perspective of a star, its photons are emitted radially. But in the orbiting frame of reference of the dust, the photons appear to be coming from slightly in front, just as raindrops appear to fly into your windshield on the highway. The car slows down a tiny bit due to the momentum of the raindrops hitting it. Similarly, the dust particles around a star lose momentum due to the steady stream of photons hitting them. Photons, although they don't have mass, do have momentum, according to Einstein's theory of special relativity. Every day, the Earth collides with 60 tons of dust in space. Much of it used to be further out in the solar system, but has spiraled inwards due to the effect of sunlight. So light is the reason orbiting dust spirals into a star. This is called the Poynting-Robertson effect, after the physicists who figured it out in 1937. But how does this help explain the slowing surface of the sun? Well, a team of researchers from the University of Hawaii, Ponta Grossa State University in Brazil, and Stanford University looked at a razor-thin layer of gas at the outside edge of the sun. And taking observations continuously for 3.5 years, they found that the very outer skin of the sun is moving even slower than the photosphere just beneath it. This is a clear sign that the sun is slowing down from the outside in. And it led them to consider an interesting hypothesis. What if it's the sun's light that is actually slowing the sun down? You know, in the Poynting-Robertson effect, dust particles lose momentum due to the photons hitting them. But we know momentum is always conserved, so those photons must bounce off with more momentum in the direction the dust particles were originally moving. Photons are stealing angular momentum from the dust, and it looks like they're stealing momentum from the outer layers of the sun, too. Photons bounce their way from deep within the sun over tens of thousands of years through the core and convection zone, and at the surface, the plasma gradually becomes transparent to light. So when a photon scatters off a particle of the sun for the last time, on average, it slows that particle down and takes a tiny piece of the sun's angular momentum with it. The team calculated the theoretical braking torque photons apply to the sun and used this to predict how much the sun's outer layer should have slowed over its lifetime. And they found it was more than enough to account for the loss of angular momentum in the sun's outer 35,000 kilometers. And photon braking is the only hypothesis so far that matches these observations. Photons were probably overlooked as an explanation for the near surface slowdown until now, because the momentum of each individual photon is so ridiculously insignificant on the scale of a star. But the combined impact of all these photons over billions of years has made an important difference to the sun. But this drag won't ever stop the sun completely. The reduced speed of the surface doesn't transfer easily into the sun's deeper layers due to the vastly increasing density and gravity as you go down. The team calculated it would take longer than the lifespan of the universe for our sun to stop spinning due to this mechanism. However, for more luminous and faster spinning stars, this drag will have a larger effect due to the higher number of photons being released and their greater momenta. It could even affect the life cycle of these kinds of stars. Now scientists are investigating how this slowdown will affect the sun's surface magnetic fields and the solar wind, things that directly influence Earth. But I just think it's cool that something as negligible as a photon could change the course of a star. Hey, did you learn something from this video? If you did, then hit subscribe and I will make more videos just like it. This channel was supported by Google's Making in Science initiative, which seeks to inspire people to learn more about science and pursue their science goals. One of my science goals is to create more videos for you about discoveries both past and present that reveal something awesome about the universe. So if you want to see more videos like this, then like this video and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time.